Hi everyone, this is Brendan here. So first of all, I'd like to say that I've just gotten back from my 8 days of Japan trip and I've really enjoyed my time over there with my family. So I really wish that we could go back there again because I really miss the food in Japan. I really really enjoy Japan food, especially the ice cream. And that 8 days of Japan trip, I've bought like 20 of ice cream and really really love the soft serve ice cream that they sell over there. So I really miss the days that I actually spent in Japan, especially last time we do go to Japan quite a number of times. But nevertheless, next month my family will be going to China and also to Maldives, but sad to say I won't be able to join them because I already have plans of my own. But nevertheless, definitely if go back to Japan, I want to go back because of the ice cream over there and the food, which me and my family really do enjoy. So that's just a small little personal life of mine. Let's proceed on into the raid. I'd like to show you guys this one done by P.body. First of all, I'd like to mention that it's quite surprising to see that I was able to push my cups quite high while I was in Japan and being overseas because I didn't attack that much because I couldn't get Wi-Fi. At the same time, I didn't want to spend too much playing on Clash because definitely vacation with your family time is more important. So I was focusing spending my time with family and definitely taking Clash to another side, putting it in another corner, not bothering about it. But when I'm back in the hotel, I just do a little bit of clouding, probably 2 to 3 hours a night. And then after that, going for an auto defense. And defenses has been really, really on my side. As you can see, this defense has scored me this win. So we will look at the second defense that I'd like to show you guys, done by Super Dave from Quantum's Web. I was quite surprised because this defense was actually done while I was on the plane flight from Japan back to Singapore. So as you can see, he was attacking using Lalumians. The previous attack was also done with Lalumian. So a lot of people are using this strategy, including myself. I'm also using this strategy. But this particular base, as you can see, is quite a good base to overcome this strategy. But it's good against 4 golems double jump also. So I really like this base a lot. So as you can see, he's having a little bit of trouble trying to get my town hall down as the town hall is probably left with like around 25% HP. So now trying to get a bit of the structures on the side and left his king and queen, dropping his queen, trying to get a bit more of the percentages. Unfortunately, he was quite far away trying to get more of the percentages, dropping his queen on the right side. And then now focusing on the left side, probably using his king over there because he has dropped some wall breakers. But I'm not really sure what he's doing. So now he has dropped his king on the right side. And then after that, now raging the king at not a very good timing because the king recovers HP like around 50% of the HP when he rages up. So that's something to note for when do not use your ability that early. Otherwise, your HP technically is like wasted. So he didn't score a win for me and I got the cups. So now let's take a look at some of the attacks that I've done. First of all, I'd like to say that I've been really really lucky to find high cups bases relatively easily as compared to last time when I was pushing to 4300. I've been finding like a lot of 20, 30 and even 40 cups bases as compared to last time, and also a lot of my clanmates have been saying that I've been really really lucky to find like 30, 40 over cups bases very very easily. So really really happy to be able to push cups this fast, and also my defenses have been helping a lot. So we'll proceed on into looking at this raid. As you can see, I've been using lava loons, and also now the town hall is basically left with like almost half HP. So at this part of time, I was like thinking how to use my king and queen to get the town hall, and of course clearing some of the structures on the left and the right of the bases so that my king and queen do not go haywire. But the minions actually did the job really, really well to take out the town hall and also not being attacked that much by the inferno because it was set to single. So that's pretty lucky for me. So at this point of time, I just dropped my queen and just cloaking her and then taking out 2 of the elixir collectors and ending the battle, getting us 25 trophies. So now let's go into my second attack. As you can see, this particular base, I don't really like the middle compartment because the infernos, they are quite far away from the town hall. So it's quite hard to use your balloons to do splash damage onto the town hall because there's no defenses over there. So hoping that there are Teslas over there, we will see as how it goes. Now you're dropping my troops, dropping the free spell to freeze up the queen, at the same time dropping my minions. So hoping the minions will take out the queen very very easily and then just continue destroying the whole base. In the middle was the Tesla, so now the minions is at the town hall. But unfortunately, the minions are being taken out by the expo, so the only way for me to now get the town hall is to use my king and queen. So I was clearing more of the structures on the right side, hoping that my king and queen do not go there, because they will get distracted to go for the structures over there. So after the minions have cleared some of the buildings on the right side, I dropped some of my wall breakers to break through the wall. Then after that, I dropped some of the barbarians and archers to check where my king and queen will actually go. So once they have continued to take the town hall, I dropped them. And then now continue to take out the town hall, scoring the 2 stars and getting us 8 trophies. So now let's go ahead with the third attack. So as you can see, this base is almost the same as the base that I'm using. But if you look at the core, the infernos are next to the town hall, which you will see later is not a good thing to have. So now dropping a rage spell and also my freeze spell to freeze up the opponent's AD and the queen. Now dropping up the middle rage spell to rage out all my balloons and dropping the freeze spell to freeze the inferno and the CC troops. And then if you can see, the balloons are actually doing a lot of splash damage to the town hall, but of course now the town hall is being taken out by the minions. Just a bit of HP left, the minions can clear it out very very easily. So with just this amount of percentages, it's not very difficult to get like 10% with a king and queen left, and also with the remaining troops that I have left. So looking at where I'd like to drop it, I noticed that the most safe point will be on the left side, as dropping my king and queen, 10% shouldn't be a big problem. Usually what I like to do is I do not go for the side where the opponent's king and queen are over there, because if my king and queen get distracted by their king and queen, it will be a big problem because the defenses will just take out my troops that easily. So scoring us these 2 star. So now let's proceed to the 4th attack. So as you can see, this base, I was actually attacking this base when I was in the main clan Mega Empire, if you look at the top right. So this base appeared and I was a little whoa, okay, let's go ahead with it. Because the cups is a little high and I wasn't expecting to attack while chatting with my clan mates inside the main clan. So I just go ahead with it. So as you can see, I deployed the troops really really well. And then after that, the lava hounds has also exploded. And then now the balloons is just continuing to do a lot of damage to the defenses. Now the town hall has gone down. And a lot of minions are continuing to clear up the base. I'll probably get to around 45% if I remember correctly. And then after that, dropping some of a minion at the bottom, trying to get that gold mine over there. And then after that, dropping some of my troops. But then in the end, I just realized, why don't I just drop my queen on the right side to clear up the structures to get that 2 star, not even needing to use my king. So we will look at it as how it goes. Not really much thing to look at, as the percentage is really really close to just getting a 2 star. Once I get a 2 star, I just end the battle and scoring us that high number of cups. So now let's proceed on into the 5th attack that I'd like to show you guys. This one, to be honest, I don't really really like this base, but it was a really high copper. This base is, to me, is the hardest to use Lalumians to attack, because if you look at the middle section there, there's a layer of wall protecting the town hall from any of the splash damage done by the balloons, so that it doesn't go down that easily. And even one of the inferno is set to single targeting, which took out my lava quite easily. So as you can see, I clear up the base relatively easily because one of the inferno was set to multi, which was a good thing, but of course it took out my lava that relatively easily. So at this point of time, I was looking how to get the town hall, because to be honest, it's not easy to get through 3 layers of level 10 walls to get my king and queen to the town hall. So just dropping some barbarians strategically, dropping some of the wall breakers to get in. And then the CC had some barbarians, dropping my king to take out the barbarians itself. And then dropping the wall breaker to bust through that wall, which was a really really lucky for me, as I know once my queen go there, there's a high chance that she will be able to take out the town hall. So now the king is just being attacked by the expo, queen now taking out the expo itself. So the opponent's king is also coming to play with my king. So now once the queen has targeted the town hall, I just let her shoot a bit more. I didn't want him to use the cloak ability, because most of the time when you cloak her, the archers come out, and then after that the skeleton traps might be activated. So this was a really high cup base. So that's it for all the raids I'd like to show you guys today. So we will look at my profile. I'd like to show you guys something a little interesting. As you can see, at the sweet victory, it's at 4,390, which is the trophies that I'm currently having. So I've broken my previous record of 4,377. So I'm really really happy that I really managed to break it due to the defenses wins and also the attacks that I've been doing today. So I didn't show you guys some of the attacks. This particular one, this 27 cups, That was a really sweet attack. I didn't manage to record that particular attack, but nevertheless, it was a good raid. So we will look at the leaderboard as we will look at the local. As you can see, I'm at number 8 right now. Hoping be able to get all the way to probably top 5, as it's quite hard to proceed on because I need like 4,400 over trophies, which I've never ever reached before on Clash. So hoping that I'll be able to reach a top 200 on the global. So if we scroll all the way down to the number 200 to go and take a look at how many trophies we need more to get to that particular ranking. As you can see, the amount is 4,512. We just need around 122 trophies to get there. It's not that difficult, but it's also not that easy because the clouding is getting really, really thick and getting really, really tough to find bases. Other than that 41 couple that I just found, which was really, really lucky for me. So another thing that I'd like to talk to you guys about is that I've also noticed that on the top left, if you can see, my EXP has been increasing. It's currently at 1,549. So apparently Supercell has gotten a little bit naughty and has increased the cap level, probably increased to 400 or 500. I'm not too sure about that. Nobody has ever surpassed that this level so far. But a lot of people have been asking me whether am I going to continue to level 400 or 500. The answer is no, because level 300 is my final goal. I'm still focusing on cups pushing at this moment, and also clan war, and also playing other stuff on my sub account. Farming on my sub account. So we will see who's the next one who will carry on the journey to 400. I'm not too sure who will carry on that, because it requires a lot of perseverance and determination to go for it. Currently the EXP to get to level 300 from 299, you need 59,000. I'm not too sure whether they will increase the increment from 500 per level to 1,000 per level. So if they really do that, I think it'll be really, really crazy for it. But we will see as time will tell. Another thing I'd like to show you guys is that I've also been upgrading my cannons as the update has came out with a level 13 cannons. As you can see, I've upgraded two of them. And I'll proceed on to upgrade the rest of the four, as they just need 7.5 million gold, just needing 7 days to upgrade. Gold is not an issue in champions, because once you do a raid, especially when you snipe town halls, you can get 180,000 loot bonus, so that's pretty sweet. So probably just 3 to 4 days I can do a cannon. Maybe in a week or 2 weeks I should be able to complete the remaining 4 cannons. But that's it for now. I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video, and clash on.